Possible none other than superstar Barry Gibb of the Bee Gees. Here he is himself.
I just want to say,
what a pro.
You have to be in the business the number of years Barry has been to know that you get the biggest and longest ovation if you enter from the washroom. And I thought that was a clever choice tonight, Barry.
Yeah, well, you know, you got to brush your hair. You got to do things, personal things we don't talk about here.
I'm personally very grateful, as you know, because I've said it to you privately in those warm and intimate moments we share. I have told you how much I appreciate your work and spearheading this entire effort.
Well, actually, it's very mutual, although, you know, I'm sometimes quiet on the subject of what you do. And I'd like to say in front of everybody here tonight, this is a very brilliant man, very brilliant writer. And I respect you very much, Alan, and I follow your work very much. And this is a funny man.
I enjoyed writing that speech for you, too, just then.
We've got to talk about the fact that, of course, Barry is going to have a real big treat for us tonight. I know it's going to be a treat for me, and that is to hear him perform. He is going to give us our own special South Florida concert, Barry, right?
Oh, you haven't heard it yet. But only on one condition, and that is that the people listening or watching call in. Let's make some money for diabetes out of this. There's a purpose behind it.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Remember, historic, folks. Get on the phone right now. Please get involved. Don't let this opportunity pass you by to be involved in this very important project.
And, of course, Alan, those numbers in Dade County are 937-CURE. Broward, take it.
797-5770.
And now we've got to talk about something serious now. Family now. Andy Gibb. Yeah. Oh, all these kisses tonight is incredible.
Good to see you, Andy. Andy has supported anything you've been real good to me, which is what I really wanted to say back on that. Remember Thick of the Night?
Remember Thick of the Night? I'll never forget Thick of the Night.
Yeah, well, you were one of the ones brave enough to come on it, and I appreciate it.
Oh, come on. It was a lot of fun.
And I want to know just also for those who follow the tabloids that this is Andy's real chest hair, too. That the rumors about this being Velcro are not right. This is all man, right?
We'll be up for auction.
Yes, you're auctioning strand at a time.
Of course, Andy, we know that you want people to call in. That is the whole idea here.
Yeah, get to the phones and call in right now, please, everybody.
And now we're going to get to tune in to Andy Gibb. So go to it.
Tune in.
Right,
I'll get this.
You're off the stage. It's my turn.
Yeah, we're leaving. Bye.
I can't use this mic.
Live television.
Here we go.
How much cord have I got?
Heaven in your eyes, I was chasing your direction. I was telling you no lies, and I was loving you. When the words are said, baby, I lose my head. Yeah. And in a world of people, there's only you and I. There ain't nothing come between us in the end. Come on, shadow dancing. All my love. one moment in your arms. I was chasing your affection. I was doing you no harm, but I was loving you. Make it shine, make it rain. Baby, I know my way. Yeah. But I need that sweet sensation. I'm living in your love. I can't breathe when you're away. Hold me down. Ah, you are the question and the answer am I. Only you can see me through. I leave it up to you to allow. Taking me through the night and the shadow dancing. Come on.
Thank you, Alan.
Andy. Hotter than ever. Lou.
Thank you very much.
Wonderful.
That's right.
Hotter than ever. Well, you get rid of those brothers and you're going to take off now like never before. Stop carrying those guys. Whoa, we're going to hose him down and... Now, we don't want you folks to get sidetracked tonight by performances like that. It's very easy to forget that this show is really for you. Andy and those guys get to perform a lot. This is your chance.
The different story on the courts this morning is more than a dozen corporate sponsors played against one another in a round-robin tennis match. Proceeds going to the Diabetes Foundation. The top four representing three companies, Fox Rackets, the Ives, and Royal Crown Cola, who provided two finalists, were presented with certificates of appreciation. They will compete in the celebrity tournament tomorrow. Another competition tonight put bidder against bidder in a celebrity auction. Among the prizes, an autographed lithograph by the Rolling Stones' Ron Wood, Barry Gibb's autographed guitar, and lunch on the Miami Vice set with Edward James Olmos.
Singing later on. Now we have Barry on tape.
That's right, Barry on tape. But
on
wait a second.
On stereo cassettes.
But wait.
On CD.
First, we got to tell them a little bit about what I found out.
Okay.
Barry, of course, married to wife Linda, beautiful wife, the father of four beautiful sons.
Linda's the father of four beautiful sons.
Barry and
well,
Linda.
Well, more about that okay. At home, yes.
And Barry, of course, has been involved in diabetes research for some time. And I learned that his grandmother, in fact, has diabetes, and that's what really spurned his keen interest in working toward trying to find a cure. Now, in just a few moments, as we've told you, Barry is going to come up here and sing his heart out for you. But one of the things I talked to him about when I was at his house a couple of weeks ago was how it felt for him to come up and perform before a live audience.
Terrifying.
Really?
Yeah. But it's a terror that you love. And when you're a child, it's the kind of, you go looking for that kind of terror. You will find an audience. You will find, you'll go to a local dance. You will do anything to put an audience in front of you that will scare you to death because that's what you love. And that's, that I think is what any top performer, I don't put myself in that category, but anyone I know that does this on a large scale or on a top scale feels the same terror.
So you are terrified of
I don't get sick, but I get that feeling of butterflies, the excitement, the terror that it has to be right, like you were talking about having to do live television, that it just has to be right. You cannot fail. And there's no room for failure. So that's exciting.
Let's talk a little bit about living in Miami.
Okay.
And certainly this is an event that has great community roots.
Oh, yeah.
You guys have been here for quite a long time,
yeah.
And the Bee Gees were certainly among the first resident celebrities. Of course, now we have Don Johnson, and of course, Jackie Gleason was before you, but
that's
you
right.
Guys were among the pioneers of people coming down here. What made you decide to come to Miami in the first place?
Well, I didn't even know Don was... I keep hearing stories that he's not living here, so...
Well, I saw him last
yes.
Sunday, so I
that
think it's safe to say that he might still be
Don,
here.
Don, make up your mind. it didn't take me long to make up my mind. I mean, I was we came 10 years ago to make an album and literally fell in love with Florida. And it's a love affair that lasts to this day, and I hope we'll just go on. I love it here. I think the attitude of the people is fantastic. I think the lifestyle here is fantastic. I think for any level of making a good living in this area, it's fantastic. And I think that eventually there's going to be visa problems just to come into this state, which I think is a good idea, boys. Keep them all out, just us. And, you know, we have the sunshine here. You don't get this all over America. You get sunshine, you get good clean air. Even if it's not the cleanest, it's cleaner than most places in the rest of the country. And I can't think of a better place to bring up my kids.
Has it been difficult for you to try to bring the kids up normally when your life is really not normal? I mean, you do have celebrities coming through your home. You are in the record business.
Yeah, it's not normal. That is true. It certainly isn't normal. But both me and Linda try to bring up the children in a normal way. So we're still normal parents. And for some reason, I think they understand that too. It's like they treat us like normal parents, same as we treat them like normal kids, you know. And they see the different celebrities come in the house and go, and we had George Michael here, we had Michael Jackson live here for a week.
Oh, my goodness, and, they must have flipped.
Well, no, you see, that's the difference. They don't. They're so used to somebody famous being in the house that Michael still calls my eldest, Stephen, calls him from Tokyo, calls him from Japan now, you know.
Calling Michael Jackson?
Tour. No, Michael calls Stephen.
Really?
Regularly, maybe once, twice a week. And they talk for a couple of hours, and he don't even speak to me. So they're really good friends, and Michael will call him from some part of the world where he's touring now. I would expect in the next few days that Stephen will hear from him again.
Let's talk about diabetes and the Love and Hope Festival.
Yeah.
How do you feel about, I mean, certainly the kind of money that you can raise in an event like this
yeah.
certainly has to touch a lot of people's lives with diabetes. How does that touch you when, you know, it's all said and done and the event is over and you
yeah.
go to bed that night and you
yeah.
say, hey, maybe I helped some people here today?
Well, yeah, I like to think that's true. I like to think that. I think we all go to bed after such an event and think the same thing. And hopefully we did. You know, it feels wonderful. It's always a good feeling to help other people. And that's one of the things in your lifetime you should do.
You know, for a lot of people who watch at home, whether it be this particular charity or something else, unless a disease has directly affected them,
yeah.
they don't realize how important it is to help. So
right.
if you were talking to the folks at home now who perhaps has never experienced anyone
right.
in their family having diabetes, and hopefully
right.
they won't,
right.
what would you say to them to say, please call in tonight and help us out?
Well, I mean, it's very hard to say come in and help when nobody in your family has this actual disease. But it's very vital, and we need help. This disease needs to be killed. And if it's the person on the street that it takes to do it, then we're going to ask them whether they have relatives or friends. You must have somebody in your neighborhood or someone amongst your family that is stricken with this disease. I don't know what you say, except that it doesn't matter whether you have a friend or a relative that has the disease. It's in your heart to do something. It's not that much, you know. It's not that much. It's not that much to feed a hungry child, and it's not that much to help in this disease either, in this cause.
Are you hopeful that your efforts, and of course the efforts of lots of other people, will perhaps one day eradicate this?
Oh yeah, that's why we're doing it. We're going to stop it altogether. That's the whole idea.
Gatlin, country singer, friend of the Gibbs.
Let's hear it for Larry Gatlin.
Yeah. He just dropped in to lend his hand and support.
How nice.
And of course, now we've got our friend waiting in the wings for us, Barry.
Oh, Barry is ready now.
There he is.
Oh, the
moment. Just came back from the restroom.
The moment we've been promising you. I'm excited about this. And, well, what else can we say?
We've
mentioned his name 312 times tonight.
The man speaks for himself or sings for himself.
And he sings his buns off. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the great musical talents in the world.
Yes.
This is Barry Gibb.
Yes.
Hello. I'll take that one. I'll take this one. I'll take that one. That's nice. This is nice. That may be nice. No, this is nice.
Barry, I'm back.
Hello, darling.
I'm back. You're not going to sing
just yet.
Because I've got someone else to introduce.
Yeah.
That gentleman over there, Mr. Hank Kellner, and he has something to give you. We're going to toast this man tonight.
Hey, Hank, how are you doing?
Barry, did you sing yet?
No, it's all right.
Oh, okay.
Keep your ears on. You're good.
And, of course, this gentleman is from the DRI, Diabetes Research Institute. Here we go.
On behalf of Diabetes Research Institute, we would like to present you with this this gift that's come from the bottom of our hearts, and what it says: with deep appreciation and affection, Barry Gibb, 4th Annual Love and Hope Tennis Festival, the Diabetes Research Institute. Together, we can outlive diabetes. Thank you.
That's true. Thank you.
Beautiful. I could hold that while you sing if you want.
I don't know what to say. Thank you very, very much. I don't think that these things are necessary. That's very nice. But I just think it's conscience that's what it's down to. I think people just have to give. And we don't have to get these things in return. I thank you with all my heart. That's fantastic. Thank you. Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think this is a good time that this is another special man that's put a guest host in our tennis tournament to Mr. Alan Thicke on behalf...
Yeah.
Thank you.
On behalf of the Diabetes Research Institute, with love and hope and special understanding to Alan Thicke, our deepest thanks, and again, together, we can outlive diabetes.
Thank you. Well, I'd like to consider... trading with Barry, because this one has a pocket for some sugar-free candies around my house, which will be... Yeah, that is very...
It does have a certain sparkle about it.
Very kind of you. As if I would ever forget this evening, that will help memorialize it for me. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, Alan.
Now what?
One more. All right, one more. Last but not least, we have to give a great thanks to WTVJ Channel 4.
Yes. And,
we'd like to present this to Robin Carter with special thanks to Brian Kadensky for production.
Oh, thank you very much. We really appreciate this. And it's our pleasure to do something to help an organization like this. But as you said, Barry, beyond the plaques and the recognition, we want you to please call up, because that's what's going to make the difference here. The numbers again in Dade County, 937-CURE, and in Broward, 797-5770. And now... the moment that we have been waiting for, Barry Gibb, accompanied by Morris Gibb on keyboards. Yes! Barry Gibb is going to sing for us now. Barry, take it away. We're leaving.
Thank you. Evening. Thank you very, very much. You ready, Pete?
We're ready.
Yeah. Okay. This song is for Hazel. Okay.
Smile, an everlasting smile. A smile can bring you near to me.
This world
will give you all my life. I'm here if you should call to me. You think that I don't even mean a single word I say. It's only words, and words are all I have to take your heart away.
You know the song, let me hear you sing it.
That's fantastic. What about a hand for my brother Morris? Yeah. Have a look. Okay. I know, you see. More media madness. Okay. I'd like to introduce now, very quickly, because we're rounding up the show, we're coming towards the end of it. I know. I'd like to bring on a lady that has become a very strong personal friend, and I've known her for most of my life. I've known her for 25 years, and when I was in Australia, yeah, it's true, I know. And when I was about 18 years old, this lady had some very, very big hit records in her home country, Australia. So she's very used to this kind of situation. Please give her a warm welcome, my best friend, Nolene Battley. Thank you. Thank you, darling. Nolene Battley, thank you very, very much. Thank you. Hang on. Yeah. Yes, sir. We're still on the air, right? Wow. We just have here a $24,000 donation in honor of Mr. Don Sofa's father. I think that is fantastic. That's come from... That is incredible. $24,000 from a Mr. Pat Henry. Pat Henry, third prize. What? In honor of Don Sofa's father, third prize in Pat Henry. You know what that means? There you go. You play for $24,000? No, I know that. Okay. Tom Daly. It was a game you played today and somebody won it and they... Okay. That's wonderful. $24,000. That's fantastic. Thank you, sir. Yeah.
No, that's fantastic. Gave it out of his heart, and that okay. gentleman is... Where's that gentleman that gave this money? Stand up, sir. Fantastic.
We got a problem with the clock. We got to go.
We got a problem with the clock.
We got to move along.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Don. Yeah. Oh, fun.